While cleaning the house, you notice some marks around your wooden chair. They resemble teeth marks, but you don't have any pets or small children. It's a sign there's a pest in your house. Mice and rats probably left those marks. You'll likely find more of them in skirting boards and soft furnishings. They do this to make their nest cozier. They're usually hiding in your attic, behind your cupboards, or even inside your walls. To get rid of them, build your own traps with a glass and a coin. Smear peanut butter inside the glass and balance one side onto a standing coin. The mouse will run in to try to get the peanut butter and knock down the coin and trap itself inside the glass. You can also use peppermint and clove essential oils to repel mice. Dip cotton balls in these and saturate them well. Place them in your cupboards, home entryways, and other places where mice like to hang around. Bzzz! There are bees everywhere! You've looked around and haven't found anything that resembles a bee's nest, but you noticed a few dark patches have been showing up for days on your walls. If you had X-ray vision, you'd see a bee's nest inside your wall voids. It's the honey that's leaving these dark patches all over. Get these nests removed by a professional beekeeper so you don't get stung. If there are still some bees left in your backyard, use a vinegar solution in a spray bottle to drive them away. Mix an equal amount of water and vinegar and shake it well. Spray it on your plants at night. If you found a hole in your shirt that wasn't here before, moths are to blame. They like to ruin your clothes and other fabrics and even your carpets. Hey, they're just trying to eat. And if you happen to find any small maggots or silken tubes, you can be 100% sure you've got moths living with you. Discourage them by using diluted cedar oil in a spray bottle. A diffuser will work too. Then make sure to vacuum your floors and carpets often so they don't come back. Carpet beetles look harmless, but also like to chew on stuff. They enjoy leaving large holes in your carpets, rugs, upholstery, and even your drapes. Clean the infested areas using a nozzle vacuum cleaner. Focus on removing the leftover debris and larvae from all crevices. To be sure they're gone, you can also steam those areas clean. If the paint's peeling off your walls, chances are you've got termites. You might hear wood crumbling down, or you'll hear them chew. Uh-oh. Knock on your wooden walls. If they sound hollow, it's a bad sign. Be on the lookout for termite pellets. They look like little piles of salt or pepper on your floor. Vinegar's the solution. Mix half of it with the juice of 2 lemons and spray it around the areas where you suspect termites to be. You can also use orange oil, and this might prevent future termites from visiting you. Spray it often if you don't want them around, no matter if they're already there or not. Powder post beetles like to chew on wood that's never been sealed or painted before. Other wood surfaces, like your dinner table, will also please them. They leave the tiniest holes in it. And if you notice your wood furniture decaying faster than usual or crumbling, it's probably their fault. Treat the wood to remove and protect it against moisture. They won't go next to it anymore. For smaller wooden items, you can freeze them for 4 days instead. Suddenly, the lights go out. It has to be the work of fire ants. They're attracted to electrical fields and like to set up camp on your outlets and electrical boxes. They're different from regular ants. They've got a reddish-brown color to them. They sting and bite. And they wear hard hats. Nah, just kidding. Mix equal amounts of lemon juice and water and spray the areas where you found these guys. Dish soap or detergent will also work. Just make sure not to spray your electrical wires. They survived when dinosaurs didn't. They squish through the tiniest of holes, and they might make you squirm. Cockroaches leave a dust of black droppings that resemble small beans of coffee in your house. You might see some of their egg capsules around, containing up to 30 of them. They'll go after your food packages, books, and leather clothing. And if you can smell something unpleasant around the house that wasn't there before, it's probably them. Stinky bugs. Mix baking soda and sugar, and then go ahead and sprinkle it all over the areas you need to. Do this a few times to be sure. You can also buy peppermint, cinnamon, rose, and palmarosa essential oils. Mix them all together and spray the same areas. If you open a book and notice some yellow stains on it alongside some holes, that's the work of silverfish. They feed off high-protein materials. Paper's one of them. They also like the glue that's keeping your wallpaper together, sugar, cereals, and dried meat. You'll find small piles of yellow dust around their feeding area and the skin they've shed around your house. You can trap them with tape. place a decoy that will attract them, like sugar in a glass container, and wrap the outside of it with tape. They can get in, but not out. Dried bay leaves spread around your home will repel silverfish. You can also leave a cedar oil diffuser hanging around. Rice and granary weevils will set up shop in your pantry. They're likely to leave a few webs around your flower packets covered in flower dust. And when you open those packets, dried larva shells will be in them. Your rice will have holes in it, because this is where they lay eggs. The first thing you need to do is throw out all the dry food that's not tightly sealed. The rest of the food in the same areas might have some weevils in them. Throw those away too, even if they're not dried food. Vacuum your pantry from top to bottom, all of it. Tidy some of the hard-to-reach spots with a brush. If there are any crevices in these pantries, go ahead and seal them with any product that works. After all this, lay some bay leaves around. Place some in your rice and grain containers too. Camel crickets almost look like spiders, or at least their legs do. They like damp basements, garages, and crawl spaces. They'll chew on anything organic, your cardboard storage boxes, your carpets, maybe even some wood items. You'll buy yourself a dehumidifier and make these places unwelcome for them. Then they'll stay outdoors. Sticky traps will work too. They can jump into them, but they can't jump back out. Your plants might have aphids in them. The leaves might be curling or yellowing out, and they'll have a sticky honeydew on them, which can attract other pests. Ants, for example, feed on the honeydew. It can bring along fungus, making your plant's leaves and branches black. Look under the leaves and you'll find these aphids. To get rid of them, try spraying some cold water on them. A solution of a few drops of dish soap and water will also work when applied directly on the leaves every 2 to 3 days for about 2 weeks. Mosquitoes buzzing around your ears when you're trying to sleep can be the most annoying sound ever. They love still water and humidity, and if you have a pond in your backyard, they're likely to set up camp there. Then they start coming inside your house. If you leave the windows open, consider getting a mosquito net so they can't come in. But if it's already too late, burn a lavender candle. They can't stand the smell of it. Burning sage and rosemary will also work. It'll soothe you while keeping them at bay. And if you haven't got any of these in your house, garlic will do just fine. Just make sure it's strong enough for them to steer clear of your home. Oh, your house is full of webs and spider egg sacs. 10 spiders are crawling through your ceiling. Flying insects like mosquitoes and flies will attract spiders into your home. Having one usually means having the other. Rub limes and lemons on your skirting boards, windowsills, and bookshelves. Any place you might find spiders. They can't stand the scent. You can also plant a eucalyptus tree in your garden. It works as a forever spider repellent. Bye-bye, bugs!